This episode of SciShow was sponsored by Wix. Go to wix.com/go/scishow to create your own website. Animals live in some pretty extreme places, but Uhini Nene Pele, or the lava cricket, might be the most hardcore of them all. It lives on freshly cooled lava from the Hawaiian volcano Kilauea, and only on freshly cooled lava. In fact, though they were long known to native Hawaiians, scientists have only spotted them a few times, always right after volcanic eruptions. And the first collection in 1973 occurred about 100 meters away from the still-bubbling volcanic vent. While we don't know as much about these awesome insects as we'd like, they could teach us a lot about how animals adapt to extreme environments. As you might have guessed, lava is a pretty terrible habitat for, well, anything, really. Surface temperatures can reach 60 degrees Celsius during the day and then dramatically fall by up to 50 degrees at night. It's also super dry, not just because there's very little rainfall on the volcano, but also because the hot black surface of the lava makes it all evaporate. And lava doesn't really hold water on the surface anyway. It all dribbles down into the porous rock. Oh, and don't forget about the boiling hot steam vents piping out sulfurous gases. It's so unwelcoming that some scientists consider this environment the most inhospitable habitat in the world. But of course, volcanic islands eventually end up with life on them. So something must see that barren rock and think, yeah, this'll work. You might expect that something to be algae or maybe a jack-of-all-trades insect that can live almost anywhere and eat almost anything. Something that's able to fly in from afar. Instead, in Hawaii anyway, what you get is a wingless cricket with a super specialized diet. Lava crickets are close relatives of the crickets that live in lava tubes in other Hawaiian caves, and they're really small. Adults only reach about a centimeter in length tops, and they're hard to spot. They blend in almost perfectly with the lava. They're a part of what's called an aeolian ecosystem, which means their main source of food is brought in from outside the area they're living in. The crickets are around long before any plants or seeds establish themselves, so they're scavengers that feed on spores, pollen, and other insects, or whatever bits of plant or dust is swept in from the surrounding forests by those strong winds. And they might get a lot of their protein and nitrogen needs from the sea foam that drifts upward from the ocean. As far as anyone can tell, these crickets are nocturnal and mostly hang out in cracks and under rocks where their food collects. Scientists actually catch them by sticking a bit of stinky cheese in a wine bottle to create a baited trap of sorts. The smell seems to draw them in like fruit flies to vinegar. And though bare lava is an incredibly rough habitat to live in, there are some advantages, which may explain why these crickets are found there. Like the fact that it's a nice open range for them to roam around, and there seems to be no competition. But since these extreme insects are only found after eruptions, and thankfully those don't happen all the time, scientists still have a lot of questions. Like, where are they when there isn't any fresh lava? And how do they get to the lava without wings? They only seem to occur far from the edges of cooled lava, and they're never found where plants are growing. And how they find each other or find a mate without wings to chirp with. I mean, that's kind of what crickets are known for. Understanding how these little insects have adapted to such a harsh environment could help scientists understand how new ecosystems are colonized more generally. And researchers are going to get an opportunity to study these crickets more. After all, Kilauea erupted for several months in 2018, and it will almost certainly erupt again. Lava crickets have evolved to be among the first, if not the first, animals to colonize lava flows, which is kind of inspiring when you think about it. If a little cricket can brave that desolate environment, surely you can go out on a limb and start your own business or do whatever it is you really want to do. And that's something Wix can help with. After all, no matter what your career is, you're going to need some kind of website. And Wix can help you get everything you need to get one up and running, including a website builder, reliable web hosting, and the best SEO for your website. You can DIY your design with their drag and drop builder or let their AI do the initial design for you. And all Wix sites are mobile optimized. So they'll look just as great on your phone as they do on your computer. Over 125 million people worldwide choose Wix to create a website and manage their business online. And if you want to join them, all you have to do is head to wix.com/go/scishow to get started.